much difference. Getting dressed.
Then late.
My buttons are bad.
Are you ready for dressing yourself?
No, sorry, just a minute. Almost there. Okay.
Namaste.
Mosquito.
This is actually really, somebody asked what it is. It's made by our friend Annette and it's got citronella and tea tree and
patchouli
as the kind
my
of
favorite.
But I think the patchouli is more patchouli is more about to get it a little bit away from the citronella smell that you get a little fed up with after a while.
It doesn't matter what it's for, it's there, isn't there?
Yeah, but I think the mosquitoes, they don't.
No, just they're giving them a treat. Nice idea. Take a deep breath.
Thank you. blessings. This is a song for Krishna. This was a song for Krishna that we got the transmission of from Shamdas in Vrindavan, walking through the mustard seed field, singing this together with Shami.
In the ashram in India, there were some Sufi brothers and sisters there. And I think the first time Deva and I ever went out on a date actually was to a Sufi gathering. I was invited to go and I think it was one of the first times we...
One of the first times.
There were more than one first.
There was one first which wasn't that.
Anyway, the Sufi path has always been close to my heart. And some of you asked for another Sufi song, so Ishkalama Budlin. God is love, the lover and the beloved. Ishkalama
Yajami.
dedicate our meditation to the children, grandchildren. For example, there's little JJ. He just had birthday yesterday or the day before, so a big belated happy birthday to you. I think he became 5 or 6. And
please don't say the kid in English. That's a surgeon.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You say he became 5 or 6.
Oh, I didn't say
kid.
I didn't say that.
Oh, great.
And I didn't say so that's JJ, and I think I said.
I think.
Yeah. And also Sophie from Denmark. She's 14. She's going through a challenging period of her life, and I was just feeling that this time that we're going through, this coronavirus upheaval, turbulent, intense time that throws everything up into the air, and I just feel let's see this time as a preparation for our young ones for a better world, a better system, and a better, more conscious worldview that will emerge out of this. So we can go through this time together in preparation for them to have a more in tune and aligned life. And that's for all the grandchildren. There's Amy who just reached out to us, beloved Amy, who said, you know, I just found out I'm going to be a grandmother, so can you please sing for all the grandchildren? So yes, I'm sure we have lots of grandchildren in our Sangha, so also for them, you know, just we're doing our best to leave the world in the most harmonious way for you and to make it a better place with every little thing that we do.
One of the nicest occasions we had this year was just before we left America. We were invited to come to a school and have a class with a young class, to about 10 years old, that kind of age, with mantras. And honestly, it was just so beautiful. They were already, I guess, through their parents and
stuff. It was Byron Bay.
It was Byron Bay, yeah. So they were already aware of the Gayatri Mantra, most of the kids. And so it was just so sweet to talk to them about it and talk to them about the their own experiences, you know, and then to sing it together in a class. I guess there was about 25 little ones, and it was just such a beautiful moment. And then we sang so much magnificence with them, and they knew that one, of course. And then we played Namaste,
yes.
And we invited them to walk around the room together with Namaste and say to each other and meet and sing Namaste to each other in the class. And the teacher at the end of the session together, such a beautiful young woman, she was in tears at the end of the, she was so touched. She said, I've never seen the children so attentive, and I've never expected to see the Namaste there. Mm. It was so beautiful.
And all because of Bodhi.
All because of our Bodhi.
Who invited
Bodhi.
Us so irresistibly.
Yeah. Teach your children well. Don't ask me to sing that.
Teach your children well.
It's a good one. Do you know it?
Mm-hmm.
You don't know it? You don't know it. You don't know it?
Which?
It's Crosby, Stills, and Nash.
You know, my tambura, now she has suddenly
reacted
to the weather, and she just kind of split open here on the side. Luckily, it's the strings that I don't use so much, so I can still use it, but this is quite strong for instruments, this humidity. And so many of you have asked about this instrument, and we've sent out the link to whoever asked. There is a link on Amazon where you can get it. I don't know the quality, because I didn't get it through Amazon. And I got it so many years ago that I wouldn't be able to give you the exact place where supply. I got it. So anyway, it's a great instrument for encouraging us to sing with a beautiful drone.
Tomorrow is our last day of the 77 days, and we're trying to fix up a way that Manoj can come and join us, and we're just trying to figure out how to make that happen. It'd be so nice. So Manoj, if you happen to be listening, then figure some way out that you could magically appear in the trees behind us. We'll see. Let's see if we can magic that. So we move into our meditation time, friends.
Seven.
So we light our candles, our incense, whatever it takes. Whatever makes your room into a temple. And then we can slowly begin to come home to our inner sanctuary, our body as a temple. Closing our eyes and moving inwards. Slowing down your heartbeat. Taking a deep breath. Our spine is straight. Our bodies are relaxed.
Gaze is lifted up to the third eye chakra.
And here we begin to be connected to our brothers and sisters across the world. Kindred spirits, saying hello to each other, namaste into each other in this silent space. Compassion, forgiveness, and gratitude.
Can already find the vibration of the Om. It's continuously surrounding us and continuously within us. And we're just giving voice to that vibration. Just enhancing it a little bit. A deep breath.
the sound of light, the ah sound, into our bodies, with the oo sound, and then into our bodies with the mm. Feel the voice resonating in your body, in your temple.
haven't spread your wings yet, this is a moment to maybe stand up, let your arms open, your hands open, and with your whole body share the prayer and spread the prayer.
Take a moment to close your eyes. And with your eyes closed, you can take a look at your third eye. See the light, experience it, feel it, visualize it, it's here. Namaste to end the meditation, and namaste to our brothers and sisters across the world. I feel each other connected through this mudra, namaste, a sign of recognition and respect. Namaste. Nidhi, this is for you. This is a beautiful song we used to sing in the ashram. So a stretch for me and David. It's going to be a nice experience for us. It's for you, man. See what I mean? It's difficult, this one.
That's so difficult. I just didn't get my note.
Mm.
You do your, you start now.
No, no, we start together.
Okay.
It's a Sufi song.
Everybody knows it.
It's not really, I wish everybody knew it.
Okay.
It's a Rumi poem, beautiful Rumi poem that says, come close, let me whisper in your ear the name whose radiance makes the spheres to dance. Oh, tears to dance.
Something to share about being inconsistent, because I realized that sometimes my idea that I should be consistent is such a prison, you know, for being spontaneous and being open to the flow and being responding to the moment. And it just came up before when we were singing Draw Near, and it's not exactly the way we used to do it. And I thought, oh, but you guys don't know maybe how it goes, and then you can't sing, and you know, and it just, and I just realized how often I am.
Don't trust me. Often you don't trust me.
It's a different thing. But just I want to just give us all to contemplate upon the fact that we don't need to be consistent, that it's not always the best thing to do, to be. Anyway, it just came up. So
it's a funny thing, because consistency is good too, isn't it?
It's also good, but it's just, there's a right time for consistency, and there's a right time for being spontaneous and being flexible. And you know, with timing, for example, I'm so trained to be on time. It was such a huge virtue that my father kind of hammered into me, like this, you know, be on time is like the thing. It's very German. And so often when...
Then she met me.
Yeah, I mean, you're on time, but you know, so often if I am in the flow and I come a little late, I realize the other person was also a little late, or, you know, it so often fits in the flow, actually, and I think that's how the countries where punctuality isn't quite such a big kind of virtue, they flow much more, and they flow, you know, everybody is
India.
Ready to, yeah, India, or so many. So anyway, just to leave you with that.
We found out here, the Spanish, that mañana doesn't mean tomorrow, it means...
Not today. And pura vida, you know, that's so Costa Rica. Pura vida, it's pure life. Loca samasta sukino. Yeah? Oh, can I then restart Instagram, because otherwise it's gonna turn off.
Okay. We've gone a long time. So.
Yeah, it's just...
Loca, different key.
Sukino avantu loka samasta 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 sukino avantu samasta sukino avantu loka samasta sukino avantu. Om shanti shanti shanti.
On time. See you tomorrow, friends, beloveds.
Namaste. Namaste. Thank you.